Let's continue with the overview of new features in the USB Oscilloscope software. Probes Manager. Formula Creator. The USB Oscilloscope software features a function for converting the output voltage of a transducer, which was used to obtain a waveform, into the value of the physical unit measured by this transducer. By default, it supports current transducers, pressure transducers, vacuum transducers, and others that were provided with USB Autoscope motor testers. The names of the transducers are displayed in the drop-down list of value indicators, as well as in the drop-down list of oscilloscope channel names. The list of supported transducers depends on the options that the user selected on the components of the installed software page during the software update of the motor tester. Additionally, users can also add support for third-party transducers using the custom probe setup menu. This capability will be discussed later on. If the list of transducers is too long, it may be inconvenient for users to work with. Therefore, in the latest version of the software, a Control Probes Manager menu has been added, which can also be accessed using the hotkeys Alt plus D. In the Manager window, a list of all installed transducers is displayed, along with information on which ones are activated and which are disabled. Transducers that are activated have a plus symbol in the Use column opposite them. Those that are disabled have an underscore symbol. If you want to add any of the disabled transducers to the drop-down list of names, you need to activate it. To do this, switch the underscore symbol to a plus symbol by double-clicking with the left mouse button. Conversely, if you need to disable any of the transducers, switch the plus symbol opposite its name to a underscore. In this way, you can reduce the drop-down list of oscilloscope channel names and value indicators, leaving only those transducers that you use most often. Returning to the feature that allows users to add third-party transducers. For example, let's add support for an accelerometer. We access the menu Control, Custom Probe Setup. In the window that opens, we click the Add button, enter the name of the transducer and the unit of measurement. In automotive contexts, the intensity of acceleration and deceleration is often measured in gravitational acceleration, which at the Earth's surface is about 9.8 meters per square second, denoted by the letter G. To enable the program to convert the output signal voltage of the transducer into the value of the physical unit it measures, a formula is needed. However, not all transducer manufacturers provide this formula. Therefore, in the latest version of the USB Oscilloscope software, a function for automatic generation of the transducer formula has been added. To use this feature, press the Formula Creator button. A table will appear on the screen that needs to be filled out. Currently, the accelerometer is lying on the table in such a way that it is affected by Earth's gravity equal to 1G. At this moment, the voltage of its output signal is 2.11 volts. Record these data in the first row of the table. Enter the voltage in the first cell and the magnitude of the acceleration affecting the transducer in the second cell. To fill in the second row of the table, we need to change the magnitude or direction of the acceleration acting on the transducer so that its output voltage takes on a different value. To do this, simply flip the transducer over. As a result, the voltage of its output signal became 0.565 volts, because Earth's gravity now affects the transducer in the opposite direction and, from the sensor's perspective, is now equal to minus 1 g. Click OK. We see that the program automatically filled in the formula row based on the data we just entered into the table. Click OK and confirm the changes. Now, we need to activate the newly added transducer. To do this, access the menu Control, Probes Manager. Find the name of the transducer in the list, and by double-clicking with the left mouse button, switch the symbol underscore to the symbol plus. Click OK. Now, in the drop-down list of transducer names, a new item, accelerometer, has appeared, selecting which we can see the magnitude of acceleration measured by the transducer. Note that the automatic formula generation function can only be used for transducers with a linear output characteristic.